Today is Thursday, January 7th, 2016. It's about 8:45 in the morning, and I'm here in the Sipsey Wilderness at Parker Falls. And I brought along my DJI Phantom 3 professional drone and thought I would shoot some waterfall video. So we'll see how that goes. Although it was a bit hairy at times, I think had reasonable success here at Parker Falls. So now we're moving on to Caney Creek Falls. What it looks like from 400 feet. This is Thursday, February 25th, and I'm here today with my friends Robin and Skip, who are over there in the woods somewhere taking photographs. Today we're at Holmes Chapel Falls in the Bankhead National Forest. Well, as you can see, there was a heavy mist coming off that waterfall, as well as a pretty substantial breeze. So that makes me nervous. So this is Sogahogdi Falls. After my first trip doing this, I decided I really needed a better way to transport the drone. So I've upgraded to a different case. Well, good morning. Today is Tuesday, March 15th, and Robin and I are here at Mize Mills Falls. And now we're at Turkey Footfalls. Wow!
Like you're biting the big one.
Ah! Come here, come here, come here. Okay, that's enough for here.
Man.
And now we're at Kinlock Falls. Gotcha. This morning, and looks like they've either been doing control burns Well, there's been a fire, because it sure is smoky. All right, today is Tuesday, March 22nd, and we're here at White Creek Falls. Okay, well, this place is a little more limmy than I remembered, and it doesn't look like there's an open hole through to the sky, so we'll just fly around where we can and see what happens. Radio good. Aircraft 98, RC battery 90.
GPS non-existent.
Non-existent, no GPS. Sensors, all within parameters. Recording video. Power up. Okay, let's try this spot, and here we go. Thank you. here at the base of White Creek Falls, and we're about to start the scramble up through here to reach what's called Upper White Creek Falls, a nice little area up there. Not sure if it's flyable though. We'll see.
For a little bit.
I was just going to say, these roots might be a little slick. Probably a good call.
There's 10 pigs that raise their heads when I say that. What a happy family.
All right, let's see what happens. I don't know.
I mean, he just took off.
It was acting, funny. Yeah. Like wanting to pull to the side.
I've got a cotton t-shirt you need to try it off.
Yeah.
knew I brought that for some reason.
It doesn't look like it. You know, none of this got in the water.
Yeah, I thought it was good that it turned over.
Actually, you're right. It just got splashed.
Yeah.
So whatever got in here, I bet I got grit. I can hear.
Yeah. I mean, that thing's pulling in some.
Yeah. You can hear like a gritty sound in there.
Yeah.
Okay, so I have dried it off. The only apparent damage, I mean, when you look at it, is just this broken prop. But the motors are, they must have grit in them or something. So I'm not going to turn, but that one's free. But all the other ones have resistance when you turn them, and you can kind of feel it, you know, so it probably sucked in grit through these openings. Fortunately, the camera and the gimbal part of it never went underwater. The water was only, it's like maybe a couple inches deep where it flipped into. So we'll pack it up, take it home, and assess the condition from there. Let's hike out of here.